VA's motto reads, "To care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan." This is a story of a nonprofit organization I visited that uses skilled hands to help heal the hearts of those left behind.
Can we flip it and see?
Here you go, Mike.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, that is so beautiful.
Stories are usually told with a beginning, middle, and end. But this time, the end goes right up front. George and Patty Lutz, and their son Tony, a soldier killed by a sniper's bullet in Fallujah.
You can see his son in his eyes. You can just see that his son is a spitting image of him, and it just really shows up in that picture.
The painting, a surprise gift from their friend Michael Gordon.
I'm hoping that you can take this and you can find some place to hang it.
Oh, yeah.
Paint the eyes first, then I have my window into the soul. That's my roadmap. Without that, I don't have a roadmap.
6 years ago, Keziah Hancock was, in her words, a fly-by-the-seat-of-the-pants artist. A ranch in central Utah, 100 goats.
She loves mama, don't you, honey babe?
And an easel a few steps from her bed, just the way she liked it. Then the radio brought the sacrifices of the global war on terror into her home. Utah had lost its first soldier in Iraq.
I'll tell you, the entire world stopped. I sat there, dead sober, tears streaming down my face, and a desire that says, by God, I've got to make contact with this family. My little deal, being an artist, I'm going to do a beautiful painting and give it to his family as a free gift to say, I'm sorry about your loss.
Her simple act of kindness to the family of Chief Warrant Officer John Darren Smith turned into a gift for Marine Corps Staff Sergeant James Cawley. And after 23 portraits paid it for out of her own pocket, Keziah created the Project Compassion Soldier Fund, a nonprofit dedicated to donating an oil portrait to the families of military casualties who served after 9/11.
It's perfect.
Keziah is painting her 570th portrait.
The soldier feels like honor is everything, integrity is everything. And when I tap into that, that is just such a beautiful place to be.
And it was a chance encounter at the state fair that expanded Project Compassion from this goat ranch to the tree-lined streets of Bountiful, Utah.
Somebody leaned over my shoulder and they said, "Hey, cutie, how about painting some of those paintings for these soldiers?"
Ann O'Born never imagined that she'd be in the company of soldiers, but she doesn't mind.
I'm not a soldier, and I'm not a hero. So the only way that I can do that is with my brush.
Ann was the first of four other artists to join Keziah's cause. Collectively, Project Compassion artists have painted over 1,500 portraits.
Every one that I have painted, there comes a certain point in time when you just look at that beautiful face and you want to know more about him.
Families that request a Project Compassion portrait fill out a one-page form, provide three high-quality photographs, and if possible, a brief description about the service member to help guide the artist. With Tony Lutz, Keziah only needed to look at the love he had for his two children.
What I love about that painting I'm working on is the love that he has for his family and his children. That's what I want to paint.
She knows in the end, though, she's only talking about brushes and paint.
Seeing that image that I had captured, recaptured in a painting with brush strokes and the emotions of going back to that moment. And knowing that was one of the last times I ever saw him.
It's like trying to put a Band-Aid on a broken heart. All that I hope to do, all that I can do, is to say, I respect what your son has done. I respect his commitment to try, at least try, and make the world a better place. And I want you to know that he has my respect.
A simple act of kindness, where the healing is in the details. To find out more about Project Compassion's mission, visit their website at www.heropaintings.com.